board an American naval vessel on the Great Bitter Lake, President Roosevelt with diplomatic aides, after the conference of the Big Three at Yalta. And here he is joined by Prime Minister Winston Churchill, who comes to the Great Bitter Lake along the Suez Canal to discuss the full use of British power against Japan. Marines at attention. Another visitor, a king. Aboard comes King Farouk of Egypt. The president extends greetings and introduces his daughter, Mrs. Anna Bodiger. Signal Corps films as President Roosevelt confers with rulers of exotic lands. He chats in French with the modern-minded sovereign of the ancient land of the Nile, the pyramids, and the Sphinx. Got a match? The successor to the pharaohs has a lighter. And it works. They discuss Egyptian-American trade. Another king, the king of kings, in fact, Haile Selassie, emperor of Ethiopia, driven from his kingdom by fascist Mussolini and since restored to his throne by the British. Lion of Judah and successor to the Queen of Sheba, he seeks closer Ethiopian-American relations. An American destroyer steams to the president's ship. Glowing oriental rugs on the deck and a golden throne. The most fabulous potentate of all, Ibn Saud, king of Saudi Arabia. The royal bodyguard, which never leaves the sovereign of fierce desert tribes. Going aboard the president's vessel like a figure out of the Arabian Nights. Mighty warrior and champion of Islam, he rules a realm of camels, Bedouin, and fabulous deposits of oil. A presidential discussion with the Lord of Araby.